Now that we've talked about arithmetic, we're going to talk about another pattern. And this pattern has to do with, instead of a common difference, it has a different commonality. And what will the next two terms be for this one? What's this first one going to be? 1,000, right? And the next one will be 10,000. What are you doing each time to go from one to the next? What are you doing? Multiply by 10, huh? Okay. That is the pattern that you're doing. What will the next ones be for this one? 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. And what are you doing each time here? Times 2. And I'll just write a couple of these and you get the idea. Okay, how about this one? What are we multiplying by each time? Well, what will the next one be? 1 over what? 1,000. This will be 1 over 10,000. This will be 1 over 100,000. And this is times 1/10, right? Okay, so seems to be a pattern here. How about this last one? 9 halves times what will give you 3? 9 halves times what will give me 3? One what? Two thirds? Let's see if that works. Two thirds. You lose the twos. This will get, yep, that'll work. So it'll be times two thirds. 3 times 2/3. Does that work? To give us 2? Yeah. So what will the next one be? 4/3. Yeah. Next one will be 8/9. Next one? 16 over 27. So there you get a nice pattern of that. All of these, what's the difference between arithmetic and geometric? Is that it has a common what? Ratio. Yep. That's the key to these guys. So in geometric sequence, if you ever want to find the ratio, take the next term. Remember when we took the difference of the next term and the previous term? Now we're going to take the ratio of those and always get the same number. Would you take a moment and write that on that slide? I left it blank for you. A of n plus 1 over a of n. Finding the nth term is a formula that looks a lot like what we had before, except what do you see letter-wise, variable-wise, that we didn't see before? R. That's the common ratio. But these others should look familiar. What's the a? First term, yep. And what's the a of n? Last term. Okay. And n is the number of terms. Yep. And that pretty much covers it. So let's say I did a problem like this. Oh, let's go fours. 4, 16, 64. And we want to know the fifth term. We want to find out what that is. So what's the first term of this? 4. So that's 4. What's the ratio? Every time, what are we multiplying by? 4. Yep. So we'll have 4 again. And what is the number of terms? Fifth term. So we're going to find it. The fifth term is the first term, a times r to the n minus 1. 4 times 4 to the 5 minus 1. Ooh, that's going to be nasty. This will be 4 times 4 to the fourth, or whatever 4 to the fifth is. It's going to be that fifth term. What will the tenth term be? 4 to the 10th, right? And so on. So that's your geometric sequence. Now, what we'll try to do is we're going to try to compare these two. The formulas on the next slide are a little confusing. They look different from what we did, but they're just looking at the previous term, add the same. Previous term, multiply the same. previous term add the same as arithmetic or geometric? You add the difference. Arithmetic. If you are multiplying by the previous term, the same ratio, that's going to be geometric, right? So just keep track of which is which. I don't like the formulas. I like the other ones better. Can you look at a sequence like this one? Put in a 1 here, you're going to get 1 over 3. Then you're going to get 5 over 9. Is this arithmetic or geometric? It's geometric, yeah. How about this one? It's going to be 1, 3, 5, 7. Arithmetic or geometric? Arithmetic, because you're adding the same. Just always do this and see if they're the same added or same multiplied. This one, unfortunately, you put in a 0, not as simple. 1 over 0 plus 1 is 1. The next one is going to be negative 1 over, put a 1 in, 3. And it will be a positive 1 over 5. And a negative 1 over 7. And would you say that's arithmetic or geometric or neither? That's a neither. Some people say neither. They're snobs. No, it's not true. How about this one? 1/2 minus 3/4 plus 9/8 minus 27/16. What are we doing in the top? We're multiplying by 3. What are we doing in the bottom? By negative 2. But we are multiplying by that negative 3/2 each time. So is that arithmetic, geometric, or neither? That's geo, isn't it? Because it's times 3, negative 3/2, times negative 3/2, times negative 3/2. So this one's definitely going to be geo. So the last thing I want to share with you is to see, once we have these nicer formulas that we developed and we use, I like these better, you can write your own formulas for these. And I would always start off with what I want, A. Now, what are you looking at here? Common ratio or a common difference? Ratio times 1/10. Times 1/10. So is that going to be arithmetic or geometric? Which one? Geometric. So the formula starts out with A is equal to 0.9. The ratio is times 1/10 each time. So the formula is going to be A of n is equal to A times r to the n minus 1. And A of n is going to be 0.9 times 1/10 to the n minus 1. That's that formula for that. And I'll let you figure out the formula for the next one. And now you're ready to complete all the problems on day 1.